Hi everyone, Grant K here for the Smoke Learning Channel. In this video, we'll discuss how to set up the ConnectFX resolution when working in the sequence. This is something we typically take for granted, but you actually have a lot more control than you think. So let's start off by clarifying how Smoke defines the resolution for a ConnectFX segment. It's typically based on the segment you initially select. For example, you have an HD sequence. You select an HD segment and press Ctrl Tab for the effects ribbon. Click Create ConnectFX. You get taken into the ConnectFX environment, and you can do any composites you want. But exit ConnectFX for the moment. Hold the / keyboard shortcut and click on the ConnectFX segment. Looking at the metadata in the pop-up window, the ConnectFX segment matches the resolution of the original clip. Now you may think that this is not such a big deal, and you are correct if the resolution of the media you selected matches the sequence. In other words, I took an HD clip in an HD sequence and created a ConnectFX whose resolution will also be HD. HD in and HD out. But what happens if the resolution of your media is different to the sequence? It's quite common these days to mix 2K with HD, or even crazy resolutions that a graphic designer might supply. So check out this example. Imagine that you have been working on a production, and a graphic needs to be composited at the end of the edit. The graphic could have been part of the conform, or you could have edited manually. It doesn't really matter. Holding / and clicking on the clip, it has a different resolution to the sequence. As a consequence of this, the segment will automatically have a resized timeline effect applied, and it cannot be removed. So that's the scenario, and you want to build a composite with this in ConnectFX. Select the segment and add a ConnectFX to it. Now the different resolution in the segment will cause an issue in ConnectFX that may not be obvious. Go to the ConnectFX Preferences menu and choose the Preferences tab. Under the schematic information, ensure the clip info pull-down is set to resolution. Come out of the preferences and take a closer look at the CFX output node. Notice that the resolution is set to that of the graphic media. Bearing that in mind, exit ConnectFX and look at the segment in the sequence. So to sum up, because you entered into ConnectFX with a different resolution to the sequence, the ConnectFX is compositing at the resolution of the graphic, and that is then scaled up to HD with a resized timeline effects. In this state, it is impossible to composite this correctly. The good news is that you have a few options when creating ConnectFX to resolve this quickly. Press Command Z to undo the ConnectFX creation. Select the segment in the sequence and press Control Tab for the effects ribbon. Under the Create ConnectFX button, you have a few options. When nothing is selected, the ConnectFX segment will be created based on the selection's resolution. This is what we did previously. But if you choose Selection as Clip, the resolution of the ConnectFX will be based on the sequence and not the selected segment. This is a big difference. Now click Create ConnectFX. This time, the information on the CFX output node tells you that the resolution is HD, and that matches the sequence. One small consequence is that looking at the source node, the graphic is also HD and it has been resized as a result. To get to the original resolution is not a problem. Double-click on the source node and look at the Basics menu. Click Explode Effects. So when using the option Selection as Clip, the ConnectFX segment is created using the sequence resolution. And the segment with the resized timeline effects is brought into ConnectFX as well. All that is left at this point is hold Option Command, drag out the resize node, and start compositing. So I'll quickly comp this over a background. Now exit ConnectFX. So the output of ConnectFX matches the sequence, and you are still able to work with the full resolution of all the media. Lastly, if you don't want to go through the process of exploding nodes, there is another ConnectFX option that will automatically do it for you. press Command Z to undo the ConnectFX again. Select the segment and call up the effects ribbon. This time, choose Selection as Flow Graph. Click Create ConnectFX. So the clip is automatically expanded into nodes. As before, you can delete the resized node and continue to work with the reassurance that ConnectFX's resolution will match the resolution of the sequence. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.